Hello everyone, welcome to Kumar Academy. So this is Satish Kumar and I have done MBA and MPhil in HR Management. I appeared for civil services and I have been coaching civil service students since 2011. So this is my new course for civil service students and for also all the students who are for competitive exam. So whether it may be any state board competitive exam, okay. So this course will be very useful for any of them. I will cover in very detail. So it will focus mainly towards the civil service students, okay, UPSC. So in the first lesson, we are going to learn about the constituent assembly and making of the constitution, okay. So the demand for constitution assembly first. So the first time the demand for constitution assembly was made in 1934 by M.N. Roy, okay, and in 1935 the Indian National Congress officially demanded a constitution assembly to frame the constitution of India, and in 1938 Jawaharlal Nehru also said the constitution of free India must be framed without outside interference by a constituent assembly elected on the basis of adult franchise. So he also made in 1938 that there should be a constituent assembly. So the demand was finally accepted by British in principle in 1940 August offer. This was the first time it was accepted, but it did not materialize. So again the cabinet mission also came up with a scheme for constitution assembly, and based on the plan of the constitution assembly, the cabinet mission, the constitution assembly was set up in November 1946, okay. So initially it was accepted by August offer, but by the cabinet mission plan only the constitution assembly was constituted, and in November 1946, okay. So when you study POLITY, you know, there are these kind of small differences, so you should be very clear, because in the civil services the exams they could easily trick you to make a mistake, okay. In the prelims questions, small differences will be there. We may be thinking that what we have written in the exam is correct, but when we came after and check up in the book, no, we will find that there was a small trap, and we lost that trap and we lost that question. So before attending the exam, we have to be very clear about what we are learning. So that is only I have tried to explain these two differences. There are plenty of differences there in the entire book, okay. And many students know, they used to say I have mastered POLITY, but they will have to master even these small details, and these small details, they miss a couple of marks in the examination and may even lose a prelim, okay. So POLITY may look easy, but it is tricky, very tricky. So we need to be very careful while learning POLITY, okay. So the composition of constitution assembly. So the constitution assembly strength was fixed in 389, okay, 389, and for this 296 goes to the British provinces, that is the British provinces directly ruled by the British, and the 93, the remaining 93 will go to the princely states. So the princely states are ruled by the prince but indirectly under the control of British, okay. So the British provinces are directly ruled by British, but the princely states also controlled by the British but ruled by the princes. So 296 for the British provinces and 93 for the princely states. So also the seats were allotted to province and princely state in proportion to their population, okay. So it was like 1 million one seat. Okay, so based on the proportion of population. Okay, and also the seats allocated to each British provinces were divided among Muslims, Sikhs and other general. So those who are not Muslims and Sikhs. So among these three communities, okay, in proportion to their population. Again, here also in proportion to their population, and it should be elected by the members of the community in the provincial legislative assemblies. So it is not directly by people. It was by the people selected to the provincial assemblies. In the so it is indirect election. That is what is meant here. So the for the constitution assembly, the people are not selected directly by the people. For the representatives are not selected directly by the people. Rather, they are selected indirectly by the provincial legislative assemblies. So keep that in your mind. Okay, this is for the British provinces. And the princes, no, the princely states, in the, for the princely states representatives, the option was the princes can nominate. Okay, so in the princely state representative, the 93 representatives, the princes themselves could nominate. So again, here also they are not elected by the people. So thus the constituent assembly was partly elected. Even that partly election was indirect election. Okay, then it was partly nominated body. Okay, so please remember this point. The constituent assembly was partly elected and partly nominated body. Okay, and then the election to the constitution assembly for provinces was held in July August 1946. Okay, between July to August 1946. And in this, the Indian National Congress won among the 296 seats, 208 seats. The Muslim League won 73 and all others won the remaining 15 seats. Okay. And since the princely state decided not to join the Constitution Assembly, the 93 states remained vacant or not filled. Okay. Only the 296 for provinces only elected. The princely state decided not to join. So then we will see the working of the Constitution Assembly. So the first meeting of the Constitution Assembly was held in December 9, 1946. Please try to remember these kind of facts. Okay, when you are appearing for any state level board exams like Tamil Nadu Public Service Commission, Kerala Public Service Commission, UP Public Service Commission, no? These kind of dates will be emphasized. Even for civil services, you need to know certain important facts. Okay. Civil services, don't think it is only conceptual. Even there you need facts. So civil service is a mixture of facts and concepts for any exam. So the weightage will be different. In the state level examination, there will be facts more, but civil service concepts will also be there, but factual based concepts. Okay, so try to remember important facts, and some facts you should remember such that if somebody asks you in your sleep, awake you in your sleep and ask you, you should remember. So such kind of facts are also there. Okay, very important facts. In fact, majority of the facts in polity will be like that. You have to be mastering polity in small detail. If you master that, you will get at least 10 to 12 marks solidly. Okay, okay. So the Constituent Assembly was, first assembly was held in December 9, 1946, and it was attended by 211 members only. Since the Muslim League boycotted, asking for a separate state of Pakistan. So the Constitution Assembly members, only 211 members attended the first meeting. So for the first meeting, the oldest member of the Constitution Assembly, that is Dr. Sachidananda Sinha, was elected as the temporary president. Okay, this was based on the French practice. The French used to do like. So this practice of selecting the temporary president was taken from the French practice. Again, here this kind of small fact, very clear about it. Okay, and later after the Constituent Assembly met, they elected a new president, that is Dr. Rajendra Prasad. He was the president of the assembly. Okay, Sachidananda Sinha was the temporary president. Rajendra Sinha became the permanent president after the Constituent Assembly met. Okay, and on December 13, 1946, Jawaharlal Nehru moved the objectives resolution in the assembly, and this resolution was unanimously adopted means it is adopted without any opposition. Everybody accepted it. It was unanimously adopted by the assembly on January 22, 1947. Again, remember this fact: the objective resolution was introduced on December 30, 1946, and it was passed on January 22, 1947. Okay, and its modified version, the objective resolution's modified version, is the preamble, that is a present preamble in our constitution. Okay, so that is very important. Then see, once the constitution assembly met and it started working, this was also the time when Sardar Vallabhai Patel met different states, princely states in India, and he was actually asking them to join Indian state. And as a result, the representatives of the princely state who had stayed away from the constitution assembly, they gradually joined. Okay, and even members of the Muslim League who belonged to the Indian dominion also joined the assembly. Okay, slowly they also joined the assembly. So by the Indian Independence Act, three changes were made in the Constitutional Assembly that is not based on the cabinet mission plan. The three changes that was made was, the assembly was now made a fully sovereign body, because before it was set up by the British. So now it was made a fully sovereign body after the Independence Act. Also, the assembly became a legislative body to enact laws, okay, to enact laws to the governance of the country. And when it met as a legislative body, its president was G.V. Mavlankar. So there were two presidents, two major functions performed by the Constitution Assembly. One is making constitution, the other is enacting laws. Whenever it met as a legislative body to enacting laws, its president was G.V. Mavlankar. Whenever it met as a making constitution, its president was Rajendra Prasad. Please try to remember this fact also. So when they ask a question, who was the president of Constitutional Assembly for making laws, no, you should not write Rajendra Prasad, you are mistaken. That is also a tricky question. Okay, so also the total strength of the assembly, which was prescribed earlier as 389, it was brought down to now 299. Okay, the Indian princes, Indian provinces was reduced from 296 to 229, and for the princely states it was reduced from 93 to 70. Okay, so the Constitution Assembly, apart from making law and enacting laws, did certain other functions too. Those functions are: it ratified the Indian membership of the Commonwealth in May 1949. Okay, it also adopted the national flag on July 22, 1947. Please remember this date. The national flag was adopted on July 22, 1947. It also adopted both the national anthem, that is Jana Gana Mana, and national song, that is Vande Mataram, both on January 24. Try to remember this fact, because when I ask a question, January 26, you may even write January 26, but it is January 24, 1950. It was the last session of the Constitution Assembly, January 24, 1950. Okay, so it was the day the national anthem and national song was adopted. So it elected Dr. Rajendra Prasad also as the first president of India. So the president of the Constitution Assembly also was elected as the first president of India on January 24, 1950, the same day. Okay, so the Constitution Assembly had 11 sessions spread over the 2 years 11 months and 18 days. Okay, 2 years 11 months and 18 days, it held almost 11 sessions. And on January 24, 1950, as I said, the Constitution Assembly held its final session, and it continued as the provisional parliament after January 26, 1950, till the formation of new parliament in after the first general election in 1951-52. So the first general election was held in 1951-52, and until then the Constitution Assembly remained as a provisional parliament. Okay. So the Constitution Assembly for making constitution constituted a number of committees. Okay. Among this committee, the most important committee was the drafting committee. So it was given the task to prepare a draft for the constitution. Okay, it was set up on August 29, 1947. Okay, and it consisted 7 members. Please try to remember these kind of facts. The drafting committee was set up on August 29, 1947. It consisted 7 members, and the chairman of the drafting committee was Dr. Ambedkar. Okay. It prepared the first draft of the Constitution of India and published it on February 1948. Okay. The first draft was prepared within 6 months of time in 1948. Okay. And the draft was given to the people of India for 8 months to discuss the draft and propose amendments. Okay. And taking all the public comments, criticism and suggestions, the drafting committee prepared a second draft, okay, and which was published in October 1948, and it took, as I said earlier, less than 6 months to prepare its draft, and in 141 days it sat to prepare the draft, the drafting committee. Then adoption of the constitution. So finally, Ambedkar introduced the final draft of the constitution in the assembly on November 4, 1948. This was the period of first reading. It was a general discussion for 5 days. So November 4 to November 9, 1948, for 5 days, generally they discuss. Okay, the second reading, that is clause by clause. The constitution was such vast India, no? Clause by clause, it started reading on November 15, 1948. And it ended on October 17, 1948. So almost for 1 year, it held the second reading by clause by clause. And it was during this time, there were a lot of heated arguments and discussion were done in Constitutional Assembly, like the modern day parliament. So 7,653 amendments were proposed during this time, and 2,473 were discussed. So it ranged from whether India need a parliamentary system, whether India should go, why India is going for a parliamentary system instead of a presidential system, whether the state should have a governor or not, whether the president should be elected directly by the people, or it should be like the present indirect election. So there were wide range of things thought, and almost all the problem that is happening today, no, whether in the constitution, they discuss everything based on its merits and demerits, and they finally come to some conclusion. And because of this nature, and all the Constituent Assembly members were also came from different areas, no, all people's aspirations were well enacted in our Constitution of India. In fact, our Constitution of India, no, is a mine for all the academician of political constitution thinkers, the thinkers, the students, academicians who want to study, no, they are actually very they like it very much, because they were actually in fact when in 1947 when India got freedom, no, everybody was actually saying that India won't last long. Soon as the British leave, India will fight, Indian different states, no, because of the diversity, they will fight one another and they will balkanize. But actually, India, even after 70 years, no, they are still a strong democracy. Not only we are united, we are strong, right? So this was possible because of the constitution that was adopted. Because of the discussion, because of the time it takes to enact a constitution with detail, right? And all this goes to the credit of the Constitution Assembly members, and especially certain people like Ambedkar and others who did some great work. Okay, so finally the third reading was held on November 14, 1949, and it was during this time Dr. Ambedkar moved the motion for the Constituent Assembly as settled to be passed after all the discussion, more and it was accepted by member. So the motion on draft constitution was declared as passed on November 26, 1949. This is the date that you should remember even in your sleep. When I ask you, if somebody is waking you and ask when was the day the constitution was passed, no, it was November 26, 1949, and received the signature of only 284 members who are actually present among the 299. Even those days itself, they have taken leave when the constitution was passed. I don't know for what reason. So 284 members were only actually present. They signed. So it was on that day it was adopted and enacted. Okay. So that is the day considered as constitution adopted and enacted. When you study the preamble, you will see that date, November 26, 1949. Indian people adopted and enacted themselves for this constitution. Okay. So the constitution adopted on November 26, 1949, it contained 399 articles and 8 schedules. Okay. The preamble was actually later inserted to the constitution, but it was also part of the constitution, and there was a judgment also there. In fact, there was a Supreme Court thing made that whether preamble part of constitution or what, but later it was decided preamble is part of constitution. Okay. You have to know first the detail that initially when it was adopted, the preamble was not there, but later it was inserted. But then the case went to Supreme Court whether it preamble was part of constitution or not, and the Supreme Court said it is part of constitution. Okay. So during the deliberation, as I said earlier, to in the Constitution Assembly, Ambedkar, no, he was a great speaker and a great debater, and he did all the deliberations, and he said why certain laws were made like this. In fact, when you read the Constitution of India in the DD Basu and further readings, no, you will know how the discussion were held and what are the reasons given for certain provisions that is inserted there. Okay. So hence he is considered as father of Constitution of India, and he was also known as the modern Manu. Okay. See, after the Constitution of India was adopted, some provisions, very few provisions, no, came into force on November 26, 1949 itself. But the provisions like citizenship, elections and provisional parliament, very few. But the majority of the provisions of the constitution came into force on January 26, 1958. Hence, that day is referred to in the constitution as the date of commencement of the constitution and celebrated as the Republic Day. And there was the reason why January 26 was selected for the majority of the constitution to come into force, because it was in the same day 20 years before, that is in 1930, January 26, the Purna Swaraj, that is the complete independence resolution, was passed by and celebrated by Indian freedom fighters. Okay. So very important fact. Okay. So finally we will see the criticism of Constitution Assembly. So even though the Indian constitution was well enacted, the critics have found a way to find certain criticism, and some of this criticism may be valid too. Okay, we need to understand that also. Everything we have, when you study something, we need to know everything. Okay. So these are the criticism of Constitution Assembly. So first is, it is said it is not a representative body. Okay. Since the constitution was not, the assembly members were not elected directly by the people, like universal adult franchise as asked by Nehru in 1938, it was considered as not a representative body, because the princely state nominated and also the provinces members were not directly elected by the people, they were indirectly elected. Hence, it is considered not a representative body. Okay. Then it was also said it was not a sovereign body. That is, it was created by British Parliament, and most of the sessions were held with the permission of the British government. Hence, it was considered under the British ambit, it was done like that. So it was said to be a not a sovereign body, but actually after the Indian Independence Act 1947, it was made a sovereign body. So this criticism is only half valid. Okay. Then the third thing is said to be, it is a time consuming, because the constitution took too much time to make the constitution. They say that American constitution took only 4 months to complete this entire work, but Indian constitution took 6 months, no, but not only 6 months, it took another 1 to 2 years like that, because of the 2 years, 8 months and 11 days I said, no. So because of the nature of the constitution and the university diversity of the Indian population and the culture, no, and plenty of things to be included in the constitution, no, it took a lot of time. And this was also criticized. In fact, a person called Nazaruddin Ahmad said it was a drifting committee. So it was going way above, right? Even students who are preparing for civil service know they may sometime drift. In fact, I was one of the students. Sometimes we may learn a lot, but sometimes we may get drift when we are learning so much thing, no? We may actually not strategize properly. We may learning putting weightage to some other thing rather than studying scientifically. This examination should be studied scientifically. You should give proper time for subject based on their weightage of marks, the questions asked. You should learn certain things very deep. You should learn certain things just once casual study. So there are a lot of things involved here. Okay, I'm giving honestly advice. Okay, then the Constitution Assembly was said to be dominated by Congress, since 211 members were initially selected. No, so Congress, so people like Granville Askin said the Constitution is a one party body, it was only Congress. So that criticism was also there, and they were also said to be it was a body of lawyer and lawyer politicians. So most of the Constitution Assembly members were lawyers, and because of this reason, no, the constitution also became so large. In fact, India's constitution is the lengthiest constitution in the world. So that is one reason. That was also a criticism made. And also finally, some Britishers said it was dominated by only one religious people, that is Hindus, the Hindu dominated body. So Viscount Simon and in fact Winston Churchill itself commented the Constitution Assembly was a body of Hindus, or only one majority community represented the Constitution Assembly. So these are the some of the criticism, but despite all this criticism, our Constitution Assembly was at despite not being a representative body in the legal sense, it is a somewhat representative body. It took care of every section of the people, and it took care to safeguard every section of the people in the constitution, and it was one of the greatest constitution that was ever. In fact, every constitution thinkers, in fact our constitution was taken from different sources, no, as a result it came so well. We will see the outstanding features of the constitution in the next lesson. Okay, with this we'll end this lesson. I hope I have given all the important facts. Please try to learn, and I will refer both Lakshmikant Indian Polity and D.D. Basu for Constitution of India. So I will also read Bakshi book. So based on these facts, I will cover as much as possible in very detail. So please subscribe to my channel to get all your updates. Okay, thank you for watching this video. I hope you like this lesson. Please subscribe to my channel, and please watch all my forthcoming videos. Thank you. Bye.